guys, welcome back to my channel. So today's vlog is gonna be a story time vlog. I've never done one of these before, but oh my god, do I have such a story to tell you guys that I felt like this needs to be my first story time vlog. So today I went to my, I guess, local, but not really local Walmart. I go there to do my grocery shopping, but not really, like I do partial grocery shopping. I get some things there, some things everywhere else, but that's besides the fact. So if you go through the main doors, like the middle doors, you're gonna come up to like where the cash registers are, and then there's gonna be a bunch of people like online, because it's always crowded there. So you have to kind of go through like a mob of people just to get to like the openness area. And when I was in that group of people, I had Briella walking next to me, Riley in the seat of the shopping cart, and Michaela in her car seat in like the big part of the shopping cart. And I just noticed this guy for some reason. Like, he didn't do anything, he didn't say anything, he wasn't acting any suspicious way. I just noticed him, and it made me really, I don't even know what it did. Like, I just had this feeling about him, like, remember his face, like, you know, keep your eye on him. So I started walking, and I noticed that he started walking very, very, very close to me, almost as if we were like walking together. He was maybe like 3 or 5 feet behind me, not even, like I want to say closer to 3 feet. And the way he was walking, he was more behind Briella than he was behind me, just like the way he stayed. So the first time I stopped and pretended that I was looking at like a shirt, but like I could see him out of my peripheral vision, and he had just stopped at a table that had nothing on it. It was one of their tax return like advertisement tables, basically. So it was just an empty table. They had yellow balloons and the sign said, file your taxes here. No papers to grab, nothing to look at. He also didn't have a shopping cart and he didn't have a basket. So like, it was just a little weird and too coincidental, but I didn't really read into it too much yet. So I started walking more and I stopped and he stopped again. Like I could just, like you could just tell when someone stopped short behind you, and that's what it felt like. And like if there were anyone else like just trying to go around me in the store, they would have gone around me, they would have said excuse me, even if they didn't really speak that good of English, like they would have done something to go around me. And he didn't do any of that. I just turned around and we were literally like direct eye contact. Didn't say a word to me, just stared me in my eyes. He was, I'm 5'4", so pretend I'm standing up. He was like this tall to me, so maybe like 5'8". Very, very, very dark Hispanic, like super dark. And he had a black beanie on. The beanie came down low and he kept his head like this, so like you couldn't really see his eyes too well, but you could. He had brown eyes, so a black beanie, black jacket with yellow writing, black pants, black shoes. I wanna say in his 50s maybe, middle-aged. And he was by himself. So after that I knew he was just following me. Like there was no way he wasn't following me. So I walked over to the jewelry counter and I got the woman's attention, and now he had followed me but he kept going and I lost sight of him. So I got the woman to come over to me. I was like, can you take something out of one of these little jewelry boxes for me, jewelry displays? And she came over and I was like, someone's following me, there's a man following me, can you please call security? And she was like, I don't have a walkie-talkie, but if you walk over to the fitting room, they'll be able to contact someone for you. And the fitting room was maybe like 50 feet away. It wasn't a far walk, so I really wasn't that concerned. And I had like view of another associate, and I knew she was behind me, so like I just had eye contact with at least someone that worked there at all times. And I didn't see him, so I figured maybe he wasn't following me, maybe I'm just being paranoid, maybe, you know, he left, maybe he gave up, I don't know. But as I was walking, I got my phone out just so I could like quickly like snap video of him or take a picture or something. And as I walked past an end cap, he was just standing there like waiting for me. And as I like kind of walked past, he comes out so fast and so close to me that like even if I were to get a picture of him, he would have been so close to me that I would have had to have been like this with my camera, and you wouldn't have been able to really like make out what he looks like, how close he was. At this point, I rush over to another associate, and as soon as he sees me going to an associate, he disappears. So every time I'm by someone who works there, he disappears. So I let them know, and they were like, security can either walk around the store with you and then walk you to your car, or they can just walk you to your car now. And I was like, I already dragged 3 kids out in the cold to do my grocery shopping, I'm just gonna have security walk around with me. And we never saw him again, but I did see another Spanish guy, like same skin tone, so a little bit shorter, and he had a Bluetooth headset, and not like the full one, just like that little one that goes over one ear. He had that on, and now I just happened to notice everywhere I was, he was. And he didn't have a basket, and he didn't have a shopping cart. So I would be down one aisle, he'd be at the other end of it. Then, you know, I'd skip an aisle if I didn't need anything. Then I'd be down another aisle, he'd be there. Then I would go all the way across the store looking at the Valentine's decorations, and he was there. And then I was down by the baby stuff, and he was there. So now it's time to pay, and I walk up to the cash register, and I noticed that my aunt and uncle just so happened to be there. So I got behind them, and I was like telling them what happened, was catching up with them. So it's them, me, security. So regardless, I'm protected somehow. And sure enough, who comes up behind me to try to pay? The guy with the headset. And what does he have in his hand? Like a piece of paper, like a poster board, maybe a poster, like the cheapest thing you could possibly grab at Walmart. I don't even think you, like, it really looks like a normal sheet of paper. So I don't even know, maybe he was pretending to get a gift card or something. I don't know, but he had like nothing really with him, no shopping cart, no basket, and he got behind me. But the way it was set up was security and the cashier had closed that lane so no one could get behind me. So as soon as he got behind me, security was like, yo, you gotta go, like, you can't pay on this line, go somewhere else. And security then walked me to my car, and I didn't see the two Spanish guys. Security waited for me to leave, and I didn't, like, no one followed me home. After I got home, I did call the non-emergency police department line just to file a report, because apparently this isn't the first time an incident like this has happened at that Walmart. And it just so happened that last week, someone tried to take a kid out of a shopping cart at that Walmart. So I'm never going there again. I don't care if I have to spend more money grocery shopping. I don't care if I have to go to a different one further away. I don't care if I have to wait till I'm child free and run to a million different stores. I do not need to put myself in that situation again. Like, it's weird because you read all these posts on Instagram, on Facebook, and like you share them because it's like local, but like you really don't think like, oh, it's not gonna happen to me. And like, I'm not saying like, oh my God, I'm a victim. Like, no, like it really wasn't like as, not even crazy, it really didn't sound crazy, but like my emotions the whole time, like I was very calm. I was already in a really bad mood. Like I had said before, like I said after I noticed him, I said out loud, I'm gonna rip someone's fucking throat out. I said that, and the woman next to me started laughing because she's like, you sound just like me. And the guy was behind me at that point. So like I was already in a pissed off mood, but I had my kids with me and I didn't want to make a scene with them because I didn't know his intentions. And I didn't want him to distract me and then them to do, you know, them to grab one of the girls or something. But I know for a fact if I were alone, I would have caused a scene right then and there being loud towards him, just because I would want everyone around me to see what's going on, see what he looks like, to recognize him, to be able to identify him. But when I have, like, just having my kids with me, it was just this whole different, it was weird. I was very, very, very calm. Like, I was very focused on, like, what I needed to do. Like, I was kind of on, like, a mission. Like, you know, like, I gotta keep my kids safe. I gotta get security by me. And I gotta get this guy away from me. And that's basically what it was. It wasn't some crazy, like, my heart's racing, I'm running through the store. Like, it wasn't anything like that. But it was definitely, like, holy shit, this guy is following me. Like, what the fuck? Like, you see this shit on Facebook all the time. And then, like, now it's actually happening. So, guess the moral of the story is just watch your back. Like, watch, be aware of your surroundings. Like, my dad always said that to me, and like, I'm definitely always aware of my surroundings. But now, like, I don't know, follow your gut instinct, because something was telling me to keep my eye on him the whole time, and sure as shit, he started following me. So, you know what I mean? It's just better to be safe than sorry. If you feel like someone's following you in a store, just tell security. Like, even if you look crazy and insane, it's better safe than sorry. I'd rather look crazy and insane and go home with my three kids alive and safe with me than hold back, be wrong on my feelings, and then actually have something happen. So, you know what I mean? Just watch your back. Just don't be careful by all Walmarts. If you happen to know where I am on the island, just avoid any Walmarts nearby. Or not avoid, just be careful. Because I'm not saying don't shop at Walmart. That's not what I'm saying. I'm just saying, I don't know, the one by me is so shitty. The people who are there are shitty people. A lot of the employees there look like they're crackheads. Like, it's just, it's a fucked up world. But if you like this video, please like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. Hit the little bell wherever it is on your page so you get notifications when I upload new videos. And that's it. Like I said, stay aware, stay alert, and stay woke, I guess. But yeah, hope you guys liked it. Bye!